I often get asked, how do you know it's time to write another book? I usually answer when I have something to say. Pages I'm holding here came about because I had something to say. Or to put it better, I had to say something. It was a eulogy, the words you say when somebody dies. The deceased wasn't related to me. I didn't work for him or with him. He wasn't a childhood friend. He was 40 years older than me and from another world. He was a man of God, a clergyman. His last request to me was that I help send him off to heaven with a few chosen words. Trust me, it wasn't a job I was worthy of. But it got me thinking about faith. In my line of work, as an author and a journalist, you hear a lot about faith. Readers from around the world may write, God bless you, but different ones refer to different gods. Our country is fighting two wars that are essentially rooted in faith. Wherever you look in this world, you find devout people, but sometimes the thing they're most devout about is that they're right and you're wrong. The eulogy request made me examine all that. At the same time I was spending my final days with my clergyman, I got involved with a project at an inner city church in downtown Detroit. This church was beyond poor. It had a huge hole in the roof where the rain and snow came gushing in. Even so, the church fed homeless people and let them sleep on the floor. And the man in charge was a pastor who couldn't have been more different than the clerics I was used to. He'd been to jail, he'd been on drugs. Where I come from, holy men don't have that kind of resume. But the more I got to know him, the more we moved together to patch that hole in the roof, the more I recognized that faith comes in many sizes, shapes, and hearts. And that eulogy request became a journey to find a great belief that's actually the same in every one of us. That journey is summed up in the title of this book, Have a Little Faith.